What conversation are y'all having with your sons?
So, my kids and I were having worship last night. And I don't know how we end up on talking about the fruits, you know? Knowing people by their fruits. And I'm asking, what are their fruits? You know, their characteristic. What are they living, what they say, you know? And the Bible says that a good tree cannot bear bad fruit, and a bad tree cannot bear good fruit. So I always tell the kids, if they want to know what someone is about, watch their fruits. You know, the fruit they're producing. Somehow, I don't know, my son gave me a look and I was like, you got a girlfriend? And he started smiling and I'm like, okay. He's like, not really. And I started asking questions, you know? Who is she? What's she about? Does she love Jesus? And he's like, I don't know. I'm like, what do you mean you don't know? That's one of the questions you need to ask. And I keep telling my sons that they are going to be the head of their household. They are going to be the one leading their family. Even though I am single right now, I know I am also raising my boys to know to be the head of their household, to be leaders. And I said, if you don't know where you're going, how do you know what girl belongs with you? You know, if you're into Jesus and your goal is to make it to heaven, are you going to pick up somebody who doesn't even believe in Jesus? These are questions they need to ask their friends or girlfriends, because they need to get in that habit now. It is not just about the Google Gaga feeling. Now, I wish someone had told me that when I was younger. But I'm not trying to save my kids, but if I could give them the information that will help them to make better decisions, then I am happy to do so. You know, information is power. It really is. So he was like, I don't know. And I was like, well, you need to go ask her. Ask her if she's down with Jesus. I mean, you want somebody who is open to him. Now, if she straight out say, I'm an atheist, I'm not into God and stuff, I would reconsider. Even though she might be fine and she might be cute and she make you feel all sorts of stuff inside, I might reconsider. After all, you don't want to be like, what's that man? Yeah, I was telling him he don't want to end up like Samson, or he don't want to end up like Solomon. Solomon may have been the wisest man, you know, full of wisdom. But when it came to women, he didn't have that wisdom. No. He allowed a lot of his wives to lead him astray, lead him away from God, not to God, to worship other gods. You know, we women have some power. My father used to always say, not my biological father, my foster father, used to always say, women have the power, we just don't know how to use it. So I was saying to my sons that they want to make sure they align with the right woman or the right girl, you know? So they need to start asking these questions from now. We want to be with somebody who is open to the Lord, not close to him. After all, you know, that woman is going to be the one who is going to cover them. You know, they want a wife or, you know, a wife, because I'm, you know, encouraging my sons to not be out there in these damn streets. No. They want a wife that's going to cover them up, you know, pray for them, who's going to be that help me, that support. You understand? A wife like their mama. No, but in all seriousness, you know, and being with the wrong woman can really wreak havoc on your life. Like we can see with Samson. What happened to Samson when he told his secret to Delilah? Yes. And even Solomon, what happened to him? Okay, he spent years in doing things he had no business doing. So I was just explaining all that to my son. You should have seen my oldest son, like, why, mom? Like, why, mom? And I'm like, no, we were going to have this conversation regardless. But seeing that, you know, you're interested in people now, we might as well start now. What do you guys think? Do you think I am doing too much? Or do you think it's a conversation that we need to have with our sons? I'm sure this might be the role for father, and I am sure my ex will have conversation with them, but right now they're with me, and I feel like it's my role to, you know, give them a little lesson on women. After all, I am one, right? Yeah, and you know what I always say, let's thank God for every day above ground is a blessed. It truly is. And it's also a day for us to have some deep conversation with our young ones. Yeah, I want my sons to be great husbands, you know, and so need to instill certain things in them. Yeah, you know, just let me know what you guys think. I look forward to hearing it. Until the next one.